drag taught me a lot about knowing who I am as a person. When you dress in drag, you're really kind of the center, the hub of the room, and you're responsible for kind of like people's happiness when they come out. I don't get that as Jason, I get that as Jezebel, right? So I have to really separate the two. Something that I've learned a lot with drag is you have to know who your friends are. I'm so lucky to have a boyfriend and Richard here. I'm so fortunate to have friends that will come and be there for you in and out of drag no matter what. Because in that 20 minutes from the bar to your home, you go from being the center of attention, having all your friends there, to being alone. And when you take your makeup off, you're not pretty anymore. Like you're a sad clown, essentially. You take off your lashes and your wig and your makeup's all busted, and then that's when you re-become yourself. I'm the only kid in my family that's like not a musician. I don't play an instrument. My mom, my dad, my brother, everybody plays. They would just like get me like, you know, put music on, or they'd play music and then I'd just dance or do like a gymnastics routine for them. So then I'd kind of like steal the show as a kid. I always liked performing. The real high for me is not so much the money and the business aspect of it, is when you blow somebody away, you know, by a performance or the conversations that you have after. Oh, I met this great person, we had a conversation about that. I love that. That's the high that I get. Oftentimes, like, masculinity to me, it's synonymous to me with my dad. This is years ago, I was probably like 7 or 8 years old. And my dad, my brother, and I spent a lot of times together. I remember seeing a cross-dresser walk by, and I remember my brother kind of saying like a really kind of backhanded mean comment, be like, holy crap, what the hell is that? And my dad is a really calm person, but I never see him really get mad, but he just like pretty much grabbed my brother by the shoulder and put his finger and got right up in his face and he says, you watch your mouth. You know, that could be your brother, that could be your uncle, that could be anybody. And he's like, you take that back right now or I'm gonna make you go up there and apologize to this person. My dad's always been like that. He's always been the most chill, cool guy that just always defends whatever is right. And to me, that's what masculinity is respect for human life, you know, and individuality and who you are. We're here talking about a guy who just, I just work in education and I do drag. And I think that oftentimes, you know, drag queens, I mean, we're men, we're dressed up as women, we channel very female energies, but I mean, I'm still a guy at the end of the day. And I like that Movember has broadened the conversation as to what it is to be male, you know. Now we're talking about a guy who does drag, and that's, you know, puts us all on the same playing field, you know.